What if I told you that all you need to build a blockchain is this simple notebook? With nothing but pen and paper, we can build a system of trust that was present with us for centuries. Stay with me, and by the end of this video, you will see why blockchain is not this very difficult, complex technology, but something very simple, and hopefully I will explain it to you in the simplest way possible. We will see how modern blockchain is a twist of old ideas, and hopefully I will give you some new ideas along the way. The title of this video is not clickbait. At the time of Jesus, apostles used something like blockchain to track their financial operations. They had certain incomes and certain outcomes, and as they were living as this commune that became more and more decentralized with time, they needed to understand where have been their assets present. Judas, for example, was in charge of group's money, a role somewhat like a centralized ledger, a bookkeeper. Much like how a single person in charge of funds today could abuse that power, Judas misused his control for personal gain. This could be considered as a first crypto scam, a first blockchain scam where trust was broken. It showed the flaws of quite a centralized approach and flaws of centralizing power. It's like the only one in control of a digital wallet today. Centralized power always leads to corruption. But let's remember that blockchain is not just about money or some physical assets. Ideas may spread in a similar way. Some non-physical values can also be traded and exchanged in a way similar to blockchain. So think about how teachings of Jesus were shared, spread from person to person across towns, cities, and countries. No central authority really controlled this flow of information. Each person who learned it passed it on and passed it on, validating it like a blockchain through their own experiences. That is exactly how blockchain works. Each node or each person validates the information before passing it along. Transaction A. Alice gives Bob $10. Transaction 2. Bob gives Charlie $5. Transaction 3. Charlie gives Alice $2. Block 1 can be written like this. It's Genesis block, first block. Transaction. Alice gives Bob $10. Previous hash, none, because it's the first block. Hash 123ABC. You create this by making up a simplest identifier. This is like your first fingerprint on this block. It's like a blockchain, chain that is constantly being built, added to, updated, and validated. So it works the same with those closed communities when they manage money, or in a way they spread ideas in our world. Think of blockchain like a road. It's the path, the infrastructure around it. A wallet is like a car that travels on that road, carrying value from one point to another. The road doesn't change. The blockchain stays the same, but the cars, your tokens, your crypto wallets move along it. They are how you interact with the road. You can imagine a library ledger where each book you check out is recorded. The ledger doesn't hold the books themselves. It just keeps this track of transaction. Similarly, blockchain doesn't hold your money. It only records where it's been and who has it now. Your wallet holds the key to accessing those books, or in this case, your tokens. But what about tokens? So a token is like a key that opens a specific locker. Each locker or block has a different key, and only the person with the right key can access the contents. When you have the token, you hold the key to the value that is stored inside of the blockchain. You probably know a lot of tokens. Token is a concert ticket. Now I'm going to a cinema, like leaving in 20 minutes, and I have a ticket. It is like a token. It doesn't hold the experience of the concert. It just proves that you have access to the concert. You are not holding the music in your hand, but this ticket is a proof of ownership and your getaway to that event. A token gives you a right to a part of that blockchain, a part of what is stored on that blockchain, whether it's a digital asset, it's a piece of art or cryptocurrency. The next block builds on the first one. Block 2. Transaction. Bob gives Caroline $5. Previous hash 123 ABC. But what is mining? How does mining work? How do we get new crypto tokens? Imagine that you're trying to open the lock, but you don't know the right combination. Every time you try a new combination, you are essentially mining, working through different possible codes to get the right one. In blockchain, computers are solving cryptographic puzzles to verify transactions. Mining is never about a brute force, it's about carefully picking the right combination. This was done for centuries. People have been deciphering ciphers a lot, like since ancient times, and mining is somehow similar to that, only that is now done through computers, through digital technology, and on a much greater scale. So imagine, like, thousands of people, hundreds of thousands of people are essentially taking part in this giant deciphering. Think of it like cracking a safe. Each attempt at opening the safe, like a miner, trying to solve the cryptographic puzzle. The first one to solve it gets to open this block, to open the safe, and gets generally the most reward. I was also trying to do mining. It was not profitable for me, like no chance, but I tried to understand how it works. I tried to look at those lines, who are validators, when does a block open, and it's very interesting to see it because you understand how you can literally mine such things in offline world, how it works, like break down to the simplest parts. Returning to a blockchain itself, it is like a growing tree. Each branch is a block. Each leaf is a new transaction. This tree grows organically with each new part being added to its trunk. Its trunk is, of course, the Genesis block, the first block that was opened. Technology simply helps the tree to grow faster, but the tree's design, how it spreads and branches out, remains the same as if it was done on paper. It was designed incredibly well, and we use this similar design for a very long time. Everything we see in a blockchain today was imagined on a small scale at first. Ledgers, records, verifications were all done by hand in the past. Technology has just scaled that process. The creativity of how we organize and validate data and resources, it started with humans, when humans just started being humans. Just like artists and thinkers who mapped their ideas on notebooks. Think about Leonardo da Vinci or other. Much like a blockchain stores data in a structured permanent way, version forms and out forms scale traditional handwriting, this line by line approach, into something completely new, completely different, that holds a lot of new frameworks and new ways of showing and writing things out. It's a bridge between two worlds. The same, like blockchain, is a bridge between those old trust systems and recent technological advancements. If you want to experience how those creative systems can come to life, merging this old approach and new approaches, come visit my exhibition. I am opening a big exhibition here in a month, and I will host a lot of masterclasses, discussions. Visiting my exhibition will be like a paper blockchain, where each new idea, each new text, each new viewer validates and aids and updates this chain of ideas and thoughts and values. You can also be a part of it, and I invite you to exhibition opening. It will be very fun, and I would be very glad if you will join. It will be on 22nd of November of this year at 6 p.m. So come and join and stay in touch here. Please leave your comment. I would like to hear your opinion. What do you think about my explanation? Maybe I am wrong in some points. Maybe I'm right. What is your experience with blockchain, with technologies, with how those new difficult technologies are essentially old, simple technologies that are just scaled. I would like to hear any thoughts of yours, and I reply to any comment. Block 3. Charlie gives Alice $2. Previous cash, 456 DEF. It's from block 2, obviously. Hash 789 GHI. Block 1, then block 2, then block 3. Each block contains the transaction details, a reference to a previous block, and a unique identifier hash of that block. That is how any blockchain works. That is how you can create any blockchain on paper, how people exchange values, goods, and money. I like how almost each of complicated new technologies that are now working like magic to us. Remember that quote from Clark? Very advanced technology always is like magic. It is not. It's very explainable. It's very simple. And that is what I'm trying to do here. I analyze different technologies and cultural processes. I show you how simple it is, how it works, how you can implement some of your ideas with different physical analog technologies, and how to see a world in a bit new way, in a new light, and with a new perspective. And thank you again that you watched till the end. I'll see you in the next videos. Goodbye.